You stay hidden and see how it should be done.
But shouldn't you have a horse?
Oh, he's a noaf.
A what?
You're a noaf.
Oh. I'm a noaf.
The next stage?
Dunno, but it's Friday, it's 5 o'clock, it's Crackerjack.
Right here on Crackerjack! Marvellous. Now straight from the boat show, and I know that because he's still wringing wet, Peter Glaze!
To talk to you about the sea and sailing. Now, what could feel better than the breezes in your hair, the salt spray in your face,
and your breakfast over the side?
Now, clean.
Yes, I washed the deck this morning. I had to. Somebody gone.
Well, you can just set sail and shove off, because I'm busy.
Just as I was saying. It's Edward Heath in glasses. Why are you dressed like that, Pete?
Because I'm naval.
Yes, I can see your naval. You'll have to get yourself a longer vest.
Leanings towards the sea.
Only when I've been about to go. I leaned too far one day, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Fell in.
It's a pity you didn't have leg weights in your pocket, you might have stayed in. Now, as I was saying.
I wouldn't have sunk, you know, because I always carry my life belt with me.
Call that a life belt? That wouldn't save your life.
No, but it's great for playing water polo.
Ewan, which side of the boat goes into the water first?
The wet side.
One time, I was a member of the York Royal Yacht Squadron.
The York Royal Yacht Squadron?
Oh, yes, the Royal Yacht Squadron. I have sailed with the Duke himself. On one occasion, we were riding out a storm. The Duke rushed on the deck and he said, grab the tiller, boys!
I'd rather grab the tiller, girls.
I took the tiller.
Where did you take it, Peter?
I didn't take it anywhere. It was still there.
Oh, you put it back when nobody was looking.
No, I didn't take it anywhere. The tiller's there to steer the ship. I had to see we didn't go off course.
Of course you did.
Of course I did. No, on course.
Of course.
On course, on course!
What, on course already? We've only just started.
Oh, what are you talking about? I don't suppose you've ever ridden out of a storm at all.
I've been in a storm, Pete. I was once in the teeth of a gale with no toothbrush.
The teeth of a gale with no toothbrush?
We were close to the jaws of...
Close to the jaws? Where was this?
In the mouth of the Thames. The decks were awash.
The decks were awash in the mouth of the Thames?
Yes, it was a mouth awash.
There's only one thing I could do.
What was that?
Gargle. Ogglecockle, ogglecockle, ogglecockle.
My father was. He sailed the seven seas. I learned a lot from him. I once took his watch. Yes.
You're trying to control yourself, you
see.
I mean, a minute ago.
Yes.
A minute ago, you took the Duke of Edinburgh's tiller.
Yes.
Now you've taken your dad's watch.
I never took.
Look at me. People are going to turn you off, you know. Hey. The mothers are going to say you can't watch Don and Pete. But they're a right pair of knickers.
You mustn't say things like that. I mean, I had to see where we were going.
Oh, I see.
In case there were any rocks in the
sea.
I used to have to look out.
What
happened? You have to look out.
Oh.
I have to run up on the poop deck and see if there's anything there.
I see. You pop up on the poop, take a peep, and pop up again.
Look, the finest moment of all is when you're coming into the harbour. You're sailing into the harbour, and there you see the mooring boys.
And what lovely lads they are. I said to Mrs. Mooring earlier this morning, I said, how are your boys?
The mooring boys are in the water.
Their mother will go crackers.
Look, you tie the boat up to. You tie the boat up to the boy, and then you drop your hook.
You can't hang a boat on a hook.
What are you talking about? You drop the anchor.
Oh, all right, then.
Anchor. You sling your hook.
Sling me hook?
Sling your hook.
All right, then.
I don't know. It's a waste of time.
Sling his hook before he's going to spring his neck there. Anyway, welcome to the first game in our new series of Crackerjack. It's the time for the girls to start us, so let's meet all the girls, our contestants in the first game. Here we have Terry, and next to Terry is Tina, Valerie, and Karen. Well, girls, it's going to be a very simple game, this, and there's going to be some nice prizes at the end. What you have to do, I'll show you, but I'm not very good at it, that's why the girls are taking part. You've got to go with your hook there, around these curly bits to the end, and the first person to get to the end without touching the metal bits, because it makes a noise, you see, hear that? Makes that noise if you hit it. The first person to get there we'll get the prize, all right, and go through to the final. So you take it in your right hand, everybody, unless you're left-handed, of course. Still take it in your right hand. You have more chance. Are you ready? Steady, go! There they go. Oh, shake your hand, use up. Oh, there's a squeak. When you do squeak, you must go back to the beginning. That's right, up we get. Oh, Tina's done all right. She's around the corner. Yes, Tina's in the... Oh, Karen, did you hit that? I think she did. Tina's going. Keep it still, Tina. You're in the lead, going slow but sure. Oh, she's doing extremely well, that Tina. What a steady hand. There you go. Oh, dear, right at the beginning. Did you get that far? That was very good. I think we're running out of time. There we go. I think... Tina. Yes, it's Tina who was the winner. So, Tina, if you'd like to come and stand next to me here, and the three of you as well, because we're going to give you your little prizes now. Would you like to come this way, Terry, and you stand next to Tina, and the other two over here. Thank you very much indeed. Well, here we've got some nice pencils for you, one each, because you did very well, although you couldn't be the winners. But you're going to go to the final in a minute to play the boy in the first of our new series, OK? But the three of you, well done for winning a Crackerjack pencil. We'll be seeing more competitions later, but now it's time for drama. We're going to see those stars of stage, screen and natural history museum. That's Sir Peter Glaze and Don McLean, joined by the lovely Jan Hunt in this very moving drama called McLean of the Munties.
Oh, Regulo 2, I'll be so glad when I've been converted to North Atlantic gas.
And more snow is expected later this evening. Here is an urgent newsflash. Mounted police are still looking for the French trapper, Porky Pierre, the notorious fur thief. People in the Maple Creek area are advised to lock their doors and windows.
Lock their what?
Doors and windows, madame!
Thank you!
don't forget the door, madame.
Oh, thank you. Oh, who are you?
I am Pocky Pierre, the well-known French trapper. Mm-hmm. I have come in here out of the cold, cold breeze.
Oh, but why?
Why? Because every little breeze seems to blow up my leaves. But enough of these superb impersonations. I am being pursued by McLean of the Mounties.
McLean?
Yes, I had a bath this morning.
He cannot be far away. That must be him now, madame. You must hide me under, remember? You have not seen me.
Oh, quickly, I'm disguised.
Oh, do hurry.
Is this number 21, Letsby Avenue?
Letsby Avenue!
No, this is number 23.
Oh, well, could you direct me to 21?
Oh, yes, well, you go down there to the post box, and you turn left, and it's about 443 miles further on down the track.
Oh. That's Andy. In that case, I'll stay here. Madam, could you put me up for the night? All I ask is a floorboard to lie on and a shampoo and set for me fur coat.
Oh, of course, Sergeant. You're welcome.
Thank you very much. I'll just leave that there to defrost for the night. I'd like to introduce myself, madam. I am Sergeant McLean of the Southeast Mounted Police.
Oh, don't you mean the Northwest Mounted Police?
No, we've moved. Oh. The gypsies complained to the council about us, and we had to go. Oh. Is there somewhere where I could hang my helmet? Oh, thank you very much. You're a dear.
Not at all.
Just a minute. A talking hat stand.
Say, could I get you something to eat?
Great. I'll have buffalo burgers and chips.
Oh.
To tell the truth, madam, I am on the lookout for Porky Pierre, the well-known fur thief. Thief.
Tell me, monsieur, how will you recognize this man?
He has a very marked French accent.
I say, really?
Yes, just like that. Just a minute. Who are you?
Me. I'm James Chevalier, the famous outstanding impersonator.
Yeah. Oh, no, he's a French chef. You get him free with every tin of blood knock sprays, beaver.
But enough of this levity. I must check that the weather is cleared, and if so, I must be on my way to capture Porky Pierre.
Oh.
What a filthy night. Next.
Next.
Yes, it's a filthy night. I would not send a womble out on such a night.
Down, boy, down. He gets very upset if you mention his relatives, you know.
Does he?
You know, I do believe it's clearing up. Then again, I could be wrong.
Oh, my goodness gracious, it's 2 o'clock.
I've heard of a Mickey Mouse watch, but that's terrific. And you.
Madame et monsieur, if you will pardon me, pardonnez-moi, I must be getting on my way, friend. Now, excuse me, because the rissole season is upon us, and I have to shoot some ready for the kiddie wickies dinners.
Oh, but we can let him go.
Why not? You've got your umbrella with you, haven't you, sir?
My umbrella, monsieur.
Yes, he's got his umbrella.
Of course,
I have my umbrella.
You see, a crocodile handbag. He is Porky Pierre, the notorious French fur trapper.
Porky Pierre, alias Jim Chevalier, I arrest you for crocodile poaching.
Ah, but monsieur, there are no crocodiles in this country.
Of course, you've poached them all.
But, how do you poach a crocodile?
In a very long saucepan. I'm going to call you and I'll hit you with me hand.
Ah, hand back! Or I shall fill you both full of several short, sharp showers.
You can't frighten me, Pierre.
Oh, no.
Your umbrella is no match for my Wellington.
Oh, and I have this shower-proof plastic raincoat.
Good thinking, madam.
You are. Yes, monsieur, I have here a tape recording of me escaping by helicopter.
While your back was turned, I took the precaution of removing the tape.
Oh, I didn't want you, Redwest. You're so brave.
Yes. Why, only yesterday I defused an LP. If it had gone off, an entire city would have been showered with Gary glitter.
Very well, monsieur le madame. You have not seen the end of me yet.
Oh, we have now.
Donald McLean, this is your life.
Thank you very much.
Page 23.
Thank you, page 23.
Read it out loud.
Even as McLean stood like a twit reading from the book, Porky Bear made good his escape by way of the window.
Au revoir, monsieur!
Not so fast. Chapter 37. Ha. But Pierre had reckoned without the ferocious brilliance of McLean's gigantic grizzly bear, who grabbed him with his right paw. Grabbed him with his left paw. Grabbed him with his other paw.
To the three-handed bear!
Magnificent McLean!
Surrender!
Tea with Goldilocks.
Ah, foiled again!
Don't worry, there's plenty of porridge where you're going. Farewell, madame.
Say, are you two gonna be all white in the snow?
All white?
All white in the snow? It's hard to tell. It's as black as soot out there.
No, wonders will never cease. Well, wonders will never cease here, because we've got time for the lads game this time. So let's welcome now Tony, John, Richard and Paul, who all come from Shirley and Croydon. Isn't that right, lads? Right, you're all from the same youth club. We're all going to have a little game now. I won't bother to give a demonstration because they'll be much better than me at it. But they've got to bounce on the cracker bouncers to the end there where the Skittles are. And the first one to put two Skittles back in his mouth at different times, right? You don't have to take them both at once. One at a time, into the basket, will be the winner. So take your cracker bouncers out of the baskets. That's it. Just step in front of your pillars there. On your marks. Get set. Go. And they're off. Who's the lead? No, it's Paul. It's got to be Paul by an easy skittle. Yes, it is. It's Paul. Indeed. Boy, you were an easy winner then. Have you done this before?
No.
You haven't. Right, one of you this side. That's it. That's it. You sit, stand there, and you come next to me there. That's lovely. And let me give you your prizes first. Right, we've got three consolation prizes, which happen to be Crackerjack pencils! And we've got seen for a long time. Well, now we've got something really special for you, because we have two of the most popular people, I think, on records in Britain. Well, I think they are at the moment, and here's their latest record. It's going to be a big hit for Donny and Marie Osmond on the morning side of the mountain.
Thank you.
just like they. For all we know, our love is just a kiss away.
But you are on the morning side of the mountain,
and you are on the twilight side of the hill.
And you and I,
and you and I
are just like they,
are just like they.
For all we know, our love is just a kiss away. But you are on the morning side of the mountain,
and you are on the twilight side of the hill. There was a girl, there was a boy.
All right, thank you very much. And now, in our first offering of the Shepherd's Bush Film Festival, Don and Pete are going to have their first attempt. They join the army and their first whack on the assault course. Try them in the RAF next time. So you've seen it all on Crackerjack.
Yeah!
What do you think of the show so far?
Well, they don't, because they're our winners of Cracker Ball. You see, we've got Tina and Paul, who are going to play this game of football, and they've got electronically controlled switches there. Let's have a look. Just wiggle them up and down for us so you can see what happens. I'm going to start the game in a moment. We're going to have a ball which is going to go from side to side, and then the person who scores a goal in the other... through the other person's goal mouth. Each time either of you scores a goal, you can select one of our presents over there. Let's have a look at them. Now, I know there are lots and lots of you who watch from your hospital beds, from your wards in hospital, and sometimes we get a lot of letters saying, wish we could take part. Well, unfortunately, of course, you are in hospital, but we do have a chance for you to take part, because you, too, are going to have prize winners watching you in hospital. We're going to have sacks of mail every week, I know, from you in hospital. We're going to take two prize winners' names out now. So, Susie, if you'd like to come along, and let's put one of the bags up here. I don't know if this is the boys' or the girls' bag. Can you remember which one this is? Let's put my hand in, take one out. This is Robin Nepal from Coombe Ward. So that was the boys' sack. Robin Nepal in the Coombe Ward of Kingston Hospital, Kingston in Surrey. Now, whatever you win, Robin will get as well, OK? And now from the girls' sack, let's put our hands in here and find this one out. Oh, right at the bottom, there we go. Ooh, I can't find anything, really. Right down, as deep as I can get. And here we can get Nicole Evans of the Evelina Children's Hospital, Southwark Road in London. So thank you very much, Susie. There are two prize winners. Whatever you win, she will get as well. All right, do you understand? So we know about the hospital kids. We've picked our prizes. Are you ready now? I'm going to start. Ready, steady. I'll get you whistle loud. Who's going to score the first goal? Good save there. No, but it's Tina who scores the first one. Have a look at the prize. What do you like there, love?
The Osmond's live album.
And ready, steady. Off we go again. Another goal. One each. What are you going to have, mate? The chemistry one you would like. OK, you're good at science, are you, at school? You like all that? Lovely. Right, next goal. And there goes the ball again. Who's going to score this one? Ba-ding, ba-ding. Paul's quick. Oh, what a good save by the goalie. I've got it! Oh, another one from Paul. You'd like the Remember You're a Womble album. OK, next goal. Ready, Tina? One, two, three. Let's see if we can get a draw this time. Ah! 3-1. He's gone two in the lead. OK. You'd have the set. The other chemistry set. OK, let's go again. What happened there? Oh, it was quite straight through, did it? I don't know what happened there. It's 3-2 anyway. You've both, not only are you going to score those, have those presents, you were going to... A Crackerjack pencil each! That's marvellous, and here they are. So here are your chemistry sets, and Robin Nepal of Coombe Ward, Kingston Hospital, you'll be receiving those presents as well. And Nicole Evans of the Evelina Children's Hospital, we got two presents. Actual fact is you scored a goal in the last minute, so you can go and pick another one, OK, at the end of the programme. Thank you both very much indeed for playing, Tina and Paul, and that was our Cracker Ball competition. Oh, that's it. You're quick. Now, just a reminder... Just let me remind all of you, though, who are watching from hospital, if you want to take part, send us on a postcard your name and the address of your hospital, the ward you're in. You can put the name of your favourite nurse as well, if you like. And then send it to us here, this address, please, on a postcard only. Hospital Kids, Crackerjack, BBC Television, London W12 8QT. Right, well, up to now, you know, I've always thought I knew how Beethoven wrote all his masterpieces. Well, I thought I knew, but it took Pete, Don and Jan to put me completely right.
I did it! My masterpiece! It is finished at last! So in the name of Ludwig von Beethoven, Ludwig von Beethoven will be a household word, especially the loo part. I must play it over for mine friend Hildegard, the housekeeper. Hildegard!
Oh, Mr. von Beethoven.
Nein, I called Hildegard. What do you think of this? What do you think of it? Mind you, of course, it's not an opus.
An opus? It's opus.
What a pretty tune. I must write it down. It reminds me of something.
Jingle bells?
Jingle bells. No! Go and answer the door, Hildegard. Answer the door. That's a good girl.
Hi, Wolfgang Mozart! Hi, you Wolfgang!
Just call me Wolf. I haven't joined the gang yet. Oh! Sorry about that, Ludwig.
It's this bigwig. I cycled here against a heavy wind.
Tell me, my friend, why are you walking so peculiarly?
Why, it's these shoes, you see.
Oh?
They're buckled. Buckled! That's what's known as a buckle chuckle. Now, I'll come right to the point.
Repeat it, please.
I have been asked to write this year's entry for the Eurovision concerto contest.
Of course, and you need a collaborator?
No. I need someone to help me with it.
And I'm sure I would be most happy to help you in any way I can. Hildegard. This could solve all our problems. This could help us to pay off the back debts. I want the higher purchase. What are you writing?
Something to help me pay off my debts and my higher purchase.
But that makes two of us.
That's a very good title, that. I must make a note of that, yeah. Very original.
No, the bailiffs are coming today.
The bailiffs are coming today. No. I like his title better.
And what she's trying to tell you is that I am broke.
Broke? Don't worry about him. That makes three of us.
Three of us?
Yeah, you're broke. I'm broke. And look at him. He's bust.
Is the bust of the great Handel. Ain't you never played anything by Handel?
Only the barrel organ.
Oh, how I love Handel's Largo.
Ah, yes, so do I. Never drink anything else.
I give my right arm to compose such music.
Well, that's what your right arm's for.
Why, the last stage is in lunch, Mr. Mozart.
Tell me, Hildegard, mine little dumpling. Oh. What have we got things for lunch today?
There's a new Italian dish, risotto al agretto.
Ah. Made in a minuetto.
I got a recipe from Jimmy Young.
Did you?
They knew Jimmy Young was old. They didn't know he was that old.
Oh, yeah. And he goes back much farther than that.
Oh, really?
Jimmy.
Back in 1780, when Bulgaria was a lad, he was minuetting in the morning. In the evening, they were minuetting mad. Mr. Minuetting Mozart was the talk of the town. And forgetting to be minuetting was letting the other minuet.
Tell me, my friend, what is a vondel?
Well, it's sort of a big hairy dustbin with legs.
Oh, Fazia, the bombers were asleep in the dead of the night.
Yeah?
You'll become a better minuetto by practicing in the candle. Fimble down for the veil, there was none that could beat the incredible and amazing young bumblebee's minuetting feet.
What you might call eine kleine light music.
That's a very good title, that. I must make a note of that.
Hey, Mr. Mitchell's the kitchen and assembles the lunch.
Oh, just a minute. Don't go without this.
What?
You'll need it to slice the hard-boiled eggs. It's just a chucky buckle.
Tell me, my friend Mozart, tell me, what do you think of this?
Well, it's absolutely magnificent. That's quite the most melodic thing I've ever heard in my life.
But I ain't played nothing yet.
Oh, I thought it was Silent Night.
Listen.
It'll never catch on.
What? My friend, my little clever dicks, you try, let me see what you can play.
Okay, I'll just play it on this. Are you ready? Nearly had shredded Mozart's there.
Come along.
Just a minute, I've lost my ear. I'll show you. I'll give you a thing on this.
Right, go on.
You've heard of Handel's Largo?
Yeah.
This is half Largo.
Get on with it.
One, two, three, four. What did you think of that?
It's atrocious.
I knew you'd like it.
My friend, your music is a sin.
My music is a sin?
Yeah.
Then your music is phony.
What?
Just a minute. Together, we could have a sin of phony.
Let's get together again. All we need is here to stay. Let's go.
seeing you. We will write, so will fine, yeah.
Did you ever sit and dream of a time when we would meet again?
Actually, but there's a sign.
Oh, they need tuning too.
They have come to take the piano and the furniture, they?
Well, keep them at bay, for goodness sake, until we have finished this.
One, two, three, four. And that's us, Ranson and Shaver. Two hands and no piano.
Yeah. Sorry, Mr. Beethoven, I could not stop, sir.
Don't worry
about it. This concerto will win us the concerto prize for sure.
Yeah, we'll get Cliff to sing it and Olivia Johnson Newt to rub him down with a wet tea bag.
Yeah. I must write that down.
Think it could be the bailiffs?
No chance. Not unless they've come back for the wallpaper.
No, go see it.
We've got it now. That's all we need to
write about. It cannot be who I think it is.
Yes, it is. It's Crunch Quick with a walking stick. Yes.
I present myself, guys and girls, I happen to be Lord Savile of Tin Pan Alley.
It's him, the top of the pops.
I was passing and I heard this sound.
Yes, sir. Going to enter it for the Eurovision Concerto Contest.
Yes, sir. What did you think of it?
Rubbish!
So his mouth moved?
No.
It can be improved, though.
Improved! The combined...
the combined words of Mozart and Beethoven! Improved!
I can make it worth your while.
Yeah, very good.
Well, it's not so much the music, it's the arrangement, you know. Yeah. Shh. Over here, mate. Yeah. Aye. Oh, great. One, two, three.
I met her on a Sunday and she helped me. I fell in love and her name was Jill.